Somebody asked me the other day, can one study law at the age of 50? Of course. When I said for the bar exams, the guy next to me was a retired police officer. His name was Aaron Abraham. He was then 59. We became friends. I asked what had delayed his entry into the bar. He said he had to help out with the family. He had numerous siblings. He was the eldest. Hi, my name is GK Gunnison. Welcome to another episode of GK TV. Today's topic is, can one study law at the age of 50? There is a custom in Malaysia, it's customary in our country, that the eldest son takes over the role of a departed father. Aaron Abraham did. I could relate to that. Aaron went into the police force. He became an officer. He rendered yeoman service for 30-odd years. Eventually, he became quite a big shot. When he retired, he completed his law degree. Finally, he sat for the bar exams. It was rather difficult for him. Aaron Abraham showed us what perseverance was all about. That is a quality that inspires me to this day. Aaron Abraham was not one to complain. He didn't say his joints hurt. He didn't complain about his blood pressure or that he didn't know how to use a computer. All he had was a pen and a notepad. He was industrious. He was single-minded. We often met for group studies. There is no better way to understand the law than to engage in group studies, especially at the bar finals. Aaron Abraham became my guide. Whenever I showed a lack of understanding of any area, he'd take me aside, we'd sit down, he would teach me the fundamental principles, one at a time, from ground up. He didn't have to, but he did. We sat for the same papers, in the same hall. When I got through my exams, this was decades ago, I drove straight to his house and thanked him personally. He declined to accept my gratitude. It was all your work, he said. We got into the bar. I remained in the city. He went off to the north, to Kelantan, and started a fledgling practice in criminal law. I believe the year was 1993. You know, as an ex-police officer, criminal law was his forte. Soon he became a big-shot criminal lawyer up north. 20 years on, I was asked to speak at a seminar. It was a technical area of the law. The hall was crowded. Some participants stood at the sides, at the aisles. I have a habit of pacing the hall while speaking. I had a hip mic, lavalier, put onto my lapels. And an hour into the seminar, I wandered, as I was wont to do, to the rear of the hall. And right at the end, near the entrance, sat an elderly, gray-haired man, bent over, consulting his seminar notes. Although he was quite tall, he didn't draw any attention to himself. And then he looked up to regard me with a smile on his face. A sunbeam it was. It was Aaron Abraham. He's now well over 80. He still gets to court every morning as brightly as ever with a spring in his step. If he can do it, why can't you? Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please hit like, subscribe, and ring that bell. Have a good day. I want to say thanks to Adi, the man with the drone, Kyril, the technician, and Joe, who looked after all my needs. I also want to thank the crew of both Seahawk, Irwan, and Hafiz. Thank you very much. There is a company in Langkawi called 101 Paradise that granted me permission to use the boat. Just yonder, over there, lies the island. You saw it in the drone. Come over when you have time. I bet you'd enjoy every minute. Good day.